Assalamu alaikum dear students, hope you are doing well. ये हमारा कोर्स है लेबर इकोनॉमिक्स और हमारा पहला लेक्चर है इंट्रोडक्शन एंड ओवरव्यू ऑफ लेबर इकोनॉमिक्स. व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स और आउटकम्स इन दिस चैप्टर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ लेबर इकोनॉमिक्स. What is labor economics? Importance of labor economics. Change in labor economics. Economic perspectives. Choice theories. Overview. Question for thoughts. The basic concepts of labor economics. What is labor economics? The study of labor economics seeks to understand the relationship between workers and employers. It is important to society as it determines wages, causes of discrimination, the impact of migration or employment, and how governments should manage recession. Very important thing, the labor economics study the relationship between workers and their employers. Labor is a measure of work done by human beings. It is conventionally contrasted with such other factors of production as land and capital. There are four categories of labor, namely unskilled labor, semi-skilled labor, skilled labor, and professional labor. अब हम डिटेल में पीछे बयान की गई टाइप्स को देखेंगे. नंबर वन, अनस्किल्ड लेबर. एन अनस्किल्ड वर्कर इज एन एम्प्लॉई हु डज नॉट यूज रीजनिंग और इंटेलेक्चुअल एबिलिटीज इन देयर लाइन ऑफ वर्क. दीज वर्कर आर टिपिकली फाउंड इन पोजिशन दैट इन्वॉल्व मैनुअल लेबर सच एज पैकेजर, असेंबलर और अप्रेंटिस और फार्म वर्कर. नंबर टू, सेमी स्किल्ड लेबर. अ सेमी स्किल्ड वर्कर इज वन हु डज वर्क जनरली ऑफ डिफाइंड रूटीन नेचर वेर इन द मेजर रिक्वायरमेंट इज नॉट सो मच ऑफ द जजमेंट स्किल एंड बट फॉर proper discharge of duties assigned to him or a relatively narrow job and where important decision made by others or higher authorities. Number 3, skilled labor. Skilled labor refers to the highly trained, educated and experienced segments of workforce that can complete more complex mental or physical tasks on the job. Skilled labor is often specialized and may require a prolonged period of training and experience. Number 4 and last, professional labor. Professional labor demands advanced skills and education. Usually white collar workers who earn a salary are called professional labor. For example, managers, doctors, engineers, accountants, bankers, lawyers and teachers include in the professional labor. Now we want to understand what is labor market. Before embarking to understand the labor market, we should know about what is market. A market is a place. A market is a group of people, group of buyer and seller of a particular good or service. There are three markets in economics. Number one, goods and services market. which we study in the macroeconomics. Number two, financial market, which we also study in the macroeconomics or monetary economics. And number three is the labor market. So what is labor market? A labor market is a place where workers and employees interact with each other. In the labor market, employers compete to hire the best and the worker compete for the best satisfying job. In this market, labor demand is the firm demand for labor. In this market, labor demand means the demand of firm for labor, and labor supply means the worker supply of labor. The other important concept of labor economics is the labor union. Definition of the labor union: an organization of workers formed for the purpose of advancing its members' interest in respect to wages, benefits, and working conditions. Member of a labor union with job protection under a collective bargaining agreement with the employer. Wages. A wage is a compensation paid to employees for work by an organization during a period of time. Wages are always paid based on a certain amount of time. This is usually an hourly basis. Other forms of compensation include salary and commissions. Another important concept of labor economics is pension. A pension is a regular payment made by the state to people of above the official retirement age and to some widows and disabled people. Unemployment allowance. An allowance of money paid usually weekly to an unemployed worker by a state or federal agency or federal government or by the workers, labor union or the former employer during all or the part of the period of unemployment. This is a new term for the developing countries because there is no allowances allocated for the unemployed people. But in the developing or advanced countries, if a person is unemployed, the government or the state should pay the unemployment allowance on the weekly basis to meet the expense of a person. Unfree labor. This is one of the important concepts of the labor economics. Unfree labor means employment against will. यानी कि किसी की मर्जी के खिलाफ जो नौकरी है या जॉब है उसको अनफ्री लेबर कहा जाता है. फिर दोबारा गौर से जरा देखिए, अनफ्री लेबर मीन्स एम्प्लॉयमेंट अगेंस्ट विल. अ पर्सन इज एम्प्लॉयड एज अनफ्री लेबर अंडर थ्रेट ऑफ डेस्टिट्यूशन, डिटेंशन और वायलेंस टू द वुमेन, टू वर्कमैन or their families. The term unfree labor is also known as the forced labor, slavery, bounded labor are example of unfree labor. Retirement. Retirement, according to the dictionary, retirement means to withdraw from one's position or occupation or from active working life. Simply we can say that withdraw from one's occupation or active working life. Industrial relations. A concept of the industrial relations, the term industrial relations explains the relationship between employees and management, which stem directly or indirectly from the union employer relationship. Industrial relations are the relationship between employees and employers within the organizational setting. Outsourcing. Outsourcing is a business practice in which a company hires another company or an individual to perform tasks, handle operations, or provide services that are either usually executed or had previously been done by the company's own employees. They frequently outsource customer service and call service functions. Now come to the definition of the labor economics. So what is the labor economics? Labor economics seeks to understand the functioning of market and dynamics for labor. Labor markets function through the interaction of workers and employers. Labor economics looks at the supply of labor services, that is the workers, and the demanders of the labor services, that is the employers, and attempt to understand the resulting pattern of wages, employment, and income. It is an important subject because unemployment is a problem that affects the public most directly and severely. Full employment is a goal of many modern governments. There are two sides to labor economics. Labor economics can generally be seen as the application of microeconomics or macroeconomics techniques to the labor market. Microeconomics techniques study the role of the individual and individual firms in the labor market. Macroeconomics techniques look at the interrelation between the labor market, goods market, money market, and the foreign trade market. It looks at how these interactions influence macro variables such as employment level, participation rate, aggregate income, that is the GDP, and the gross domestic product. Now we study the importance of the labor economics. Socioeconomic issues. Labor economics handle the socioeconomic issues like gender and race, like discrimination, like legal and illegal immigration, and fall in unionization and free trade. Number two, quantitative importance. 75% of the national income goes to labor. Number three, unique characteristics. Labor is rented and not bought, sold. Non-monetary aspect. Institutional factors like union, licensing, minimum wage laws, and discrimination. Labor demand is a drive demand. What is the old and new in the labor economics? Change in the labor economics. What is the old approach of the labor economics? The old approach in the labor economics highly descriptive and historical. Little economic analysis. The complexities of the labor markets seem to make more or less immune to economic analysis. What new in the labor economics? In the modern time, labor economics uses the applied micro and macroeconomic theories as we discussed in the previous slide. Economic perspective. choice theory. Labor economics uses the theories of choice to explain the behavior of the labor market participants and resulting outcomes. These theories based on the three important assumptions which we already study in the microeconomics: relative scarcity, purposeful behavior, and adaptability. Now we define the microeconomics versus macroeconomics, because in the labor economics we extensively use the tools of the microeconomics to study the individual behavior of the labor and individual market, and the macroeconomics tools to study of the overall economy behavior and interaction with the labor market, with the money market, with the goods and services market, and with the international trade market. So microeconomics studies the economy at an individual level. Some examples of the microeconomics include the supply, demand, competition, and the prices of the items, while the macroeconomics studies the economy from a large scale as a whole perspective, such as on a city, country, and a national level. Question for thoughts. Why must concept of supply and demand as they pertain to products be modified when applied to labor markets? Indicate whether each of the following statements pertains to microeconomics or macroeconomics. लेकिन नीचे जो स्टेटमेंट मैं बोलूंगा या लिखी हुई है, आपने ये जज करना है कि ये माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स से रिलेटेड स्टेटमेंट्स हैं या फिर मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स से रिलेटेड है. फॉर एग्जांपल, द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट वाज 4.6% इन 2006. सिंपली पूरे यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स के अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट को देखा जा रहा है, तो ये क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स है. Bartenders at Andrew's Capital Bar and Grill earn 9.2 per hour. ये कोई person है जो कि Capital Bar and Grill से 9.2 per hour wages ले रहा है. तो this is obviously, क्योंकि individual की बात है तो microeconomics की statement है. The productivity of American workers as a whole has increased by more than 2% per year in the last 4% per year in the last 4 years. तो ये क्योंकि ओवरऑल पूरे अमेरिका की बात कर रहे हैं, इस वजह से ये क्वेश्चन मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स का है. बिकॉज द मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स स्टडी द इकोनॉमी एज ए होल एंड माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स स्टडी द इकोनॉमिक्स एज इंडिविजुअल, इंडिविजुअल पर्सन और इंडिविजुअल फर्म, बोथ इंक्लूडेड इन द माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. थैंक यू.